Tamron just released their newest and greatest Tamron 70-180 2.8, and I am here to give my totally professional thoughts about it. But in all honesty, it's not a bad lens at all. At first I thought I would not like it at all, and after the first couple of days of shooting with it, I still didn't like it at all. However, that was due to the fact that I simply didn't know how to use it. Now, after having it tested out for a month or so, I've done a bunch of photo shoots, a bunch of video shoots with it, so I think I'm ready to give my honest opinion. Let's start with the design. I have only worked with a couple of 70-200s, and they are all huge, absolutely huge. This lens is not tiny by any means, but compared to the other ones, it's really small and lightweight. It weighs only 810 grams. And yeah, overall, I love the design, I have nothing to complain about. I even got a couple of compliments from girls saying that my lens was really big, so I got that thing going for me. I tested this lens on both Sony a7 III and Sony Alpha 6500. On Sony a7 III, I called up a friend so we could both test it out together because I'm too poor for that camera. But he said it was the snappiest and fastest autofocus he has ever seen due to the new VXD linear motor focus mechanism. And here are some cool tests we did. However, since my main workhorse is Sony Alpha 6500, I did a bunch of tests with that system, and here are some of the best videos and photos I got from this lens. Even on an APS-C camera, the autofocus was very accurate and fast. And let's not even begin talking about the sharpness. I don't think I've ever had such sharp photos in my life. On to the next topic, bokeh. Man, I don't think I have anything to say here. Just look at those creamy balls. Did we experience any issues? Well, for the most part, it was a very smooth experience. However, when we mounted this lens on the Sony a7 III, sometimes it would go out of focus when I got kind of close to the lens in burst mode. However, when we switched the mode from burst to a single shot, we could get a lot closer to the lens with me being perfectly in focus. So yeah, it feels like in burst mode, the minimal focus distance is a lot further than in single take mode, which is weird, but I mean, okay. And yes, we had the focus settings to the most responsive and fastest. And last but not least, the price. Since the Tamron 17-28 and 28-75 was around $700, I expected this lens to be around the same price as well, to be honest. However, at least here in Europe, it will be sold for around $1,500, which is, yeah, at least 5 months worth of my rent money. So, no thank you. In the US, however, it will be around $1,200, so you can go and shove the number up your ass. All in all, just like I said, this lens is not really for me. I am more of a wide angle kind of a guy, but I gotta admit, it was very fun to test it out, I definitely do love taking photos with it. I wanna hear your opinion, what do you think about the lens? Well, anyway, it was nice seeing you here, and as always, you know the drill, peace out.